Relax. You're young. You have your whole life ahead of you.
But be very smart of all of the lessons that need to be learned within this decade. And if you don't get them all at once, relax, because
it's all in God's hands anyway. So here are the lessons I learned in my 20s. Choice, an act of selecting or making a decision when faced with more possibilities. So the number one thing I believe that the youth should learn in their 20s is realizing that you are young and that you have choices. Whether you're in your late 20s or early 20s, you have the whole world at your feet. You're probably in the best physical shape. You have the energy and stamina to complete your goals. And guess what? Even if you mess up, you have so much wiggle room to fix it or pivot. So, what are your dreams, wants, and needs?
Nothing and no one held you back. What would your days look like? What would your schedule be? Where would you spend your time? Who would you spend it with? What are the things you would be known for?
Knowing what you want in your life is very, very crucial. There are people right now taking anything simply because they don't know what they want. So identify what you want, and if you don't know how to get it, teach yourself. Today, right now, you have access to a computer or a phone. You can look up how to learn on any subject matter in the world. You have access to a library. You have access to Barnes and Nobles. You have access to learn how to do anything you want to do. You don't have to study through an institution to make something of your life. I meet so many young ladies in their 20s feeling like they're so handcuffed to their circumstances. And their complaints are, oh, I can't leave that job. Even though it pays me minimum wage, I can't leave it. It's all I got right now. Or I can't leave my hometown. Or I got these kids and I'm so stressed out and I can't leave that man. And it's such a lie. Right here, right now, you can become whoever you want. Most rich people were rags to riches stories. All they did, they were just committed, self-disciplined, learned the information they didn't have, and then voila, their dreams came true. They got results. Don't let nobody tell you you can't make it or you can't make millions. There are 24, 28-year-old millionaires right here, right now, successful all off of their ideas.
Intuition, the ability to understand something immediately without the need for conscious reasoning. Number two, trust your intuition, aka yourself. Just that gut feeling. We often question it or ignore our intuition because there's no logical reason to believe it, right? It's just the first thing that came to mind. Or the fact that we are so programmed to trust others more than ourselves. Remember, the previous decade, you were a child. Your parents told you what to do, what not to do, what to say. You know, our parents, our teachers, our mentors, the principals, just any adult figure. We're so used to them telling us what to do. But now that you're grown and on your own, you got to tell yourself what to do and what not to do. And sometimes we can get so caught up in the YOLO and I'm grown and I don't care and I'm invincible that we don't pay attention to our gut feeling, our intuition. Your intuition is there to protect you. It's there to guide you. But it can only work if you're willing to listen. So you young mother effer you, please, please stop, pause, and pay attention to your intuition. Check in with your intuition before you make any big decisions. And even if you fumble, even if you make a mistake and don't listen to your intuition, the next time it just gives you reinsurance to trust it. Because our intuition doesn't prove us wrong. It proves us right. Because we knew from the jump that someone or something just wasn't right. Detachment is when you're able to recognize, acknowledge, and finally let go of emotions such as anger, hurt, sadness without becoming consumed by them. Number three, learn the art of detachment.
There comes a time to say hi
and there comes a time to say goodbye. Everything and everyone has an expiration date on it.
I want you to stop, pause, and take inventory of all your relationships to see if they are still serving you in the way that you need them to. Sometimes we don't want to let go of certain people no matter how bad they treat us. We're used to them, we're used to it, but if you don't learn the art of detachment, you are going to struggle badly when these people leave your life, because I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but 9 times out of 10, the very people you thought they were going to be there in your 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, all the way up until death, you thought that they was going to be there forever, and they're not. People come and go like clockwork. Ain't none of this shit promised. Nothing. Sometimes people grow apart. Sometimes people turn into different people. You can literally blink your eyes and all of a sudden they've changed. They're not the same. You know, they're not supporting you the way they used to, or they're mean, or they've grown abusive, or they're taking their trauma out on you. And there comes a time where you need to cut them off.
Remember,
you're only as needy as your unmet needs. So 9 times out of 10, it's not the person, it's how they make you feel, and that's what you're attached to. It's not necessarily the person, it's the feeling. So figure out your needs, and if they can't supply your needs, or they are taking more than they are giving, it's time to let them go.
There is an expiration date attached to everything.
Great deal of effort or endurance. Tip number 4, hard work is necessary. No one is coming to save you, sweetheart. I mean, nobody. But understand that you are your best friend. You are your hype man. You are your business partner. You are your own friend. It is a lonely road to success, and hard work is necessary. You are not getting nothing handed to you. If you want to have a massive amount of success, there's going to be some setbacks, some delays, some depression, some days you think you ain't gonna make it, and guess what? Ain't nobody come to save you or even help you. And don't look for sympathy.
We look for solutions, not sympathy.
Life is too short to not be lived how you want it to be. You have choices. Trust your intuition. Understand you're going to have to detach from people and circumstances. But also have fun. It's not too late. Even if you mess up, you got time to recover. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you learned anything, let me know in the comments below. Remember, without a doubt, you're beautiful inside and out.
You are the director, the creator, and the writer of your story. You literally could do whatever you want. And it's just for you to sit down and navigate where you want to go. And you will get there.